Welcome to the Heart and Soul programs of India Bridge to Life Ministries. As we are passing through the days of 2018, we know that we are going to be more blessings to our life, our people's life, the life in a church and a society. Thank God for what He has done for us for the last 1 month time, for the last 1 week time. God is good to us. So suppose when we are looking on the life with a great ambition, but the question is, are we looking properly to find its challenges? Because we are all having a phobia or a fear full approach to our life. What will going to me? Why it will going to happen to me, my situation, my people and all? But don't focus on that things, because the God's promise, as long as the God's promise is with you, God is able to provide you and meet you, or meet your all the needs according to His righteousness and glory. God's standard is immeasurable. When you relate with God, your standard will be more high. You will be more able to digest things. So God's plan is like that. When we are studying the book of the Gospel of John 3, we know that one of the famous teacher, a Pharisee, Nicodemus, he was a ruler of the Jews. That means he is holding a high post. Ruler means one who is able to lead people, judge people, and he is a leader in all that sense. This man came to Jesus by night and asked him, "Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher come from God, and no one can do these things that you do unless God is with him." Nicodemus was a wise man, a eminent ruler, efficient leader, a man of wisdom. He looked into the Jesus as he is one of the citizens of that country. And he was keenly observing the activities of Jesus. And Nicodemus recognize one thing, that Jesus could not perform these miracles unless God sanctioned him to do this one. But as he was carrying that idea in his mind, he selected a one fine time, that is the night. No one could easily watch him, because he could have covered with his long dresses, and he approached Jesus. And he raised such a things that you are a teacher, come from God. This ruler, Nicodemus, appreciated Jesus and said, you are a good teacher. You are coming from God. And the signs which you are showing is not an, things from the world, but it is from God. Then Jesus said, most assuredly, I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Jesus never counted the post he was holding on, but Jesus directly interact with Nicodemus and telling that, Nicodemus, one thing I will tell you, most assuredly I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. What is the need here? What's the need of Nicodemus to come to Jesus? So he came to connect with Jesus, that Jesus was a good teacher. The good teacher teaches him good things. The first good things he was mentioning, that unless you born again, you cannot enter into the kingdom. So while hearing this, this man raised another question. How can a person become a newborn? How can he become a baby again? How can he enter the womb of his mother again? Logically, these are all making no sense to me. But Jesus said very clearly, are you a teacher of the Israel and do not know these things? Most assuredly I say to you, we speak what we know and testify what we have seen, and you do not receive our witness. So this is a problem for many people. They do not accept what they have supposed to accept in their life. Jesus said the same thing to this person. You are not ready to accept what you are looking for. That means you could not relate the things which will meet your needs. You are still searching. Still searching. The same thing Jesus would ask to that woman in the next chapter 4 of John Gospel chapter 4. Samaritan woman is talking about the water in the well. Jesus is talking about the water in the heaven. An eternal water, a living water. Whoever drinks that water will not thirst it again. Slowly, she should digest that he is talking something that is different. He responded to Jesus. If that water can satisfy my thirst, will you please give me that water? Jesus answered, bring your husband. She said that, I know husband, but you had 5 husbands. Jesus explained this thing, her life story to her, and she was excited and willing to accept the words of Jesus. Though he was a sinner, she was able to accept the words of Jesus because she was in real need. She wanted to change her lifestyle. She wanted to escape from the position she was holding on, wife of a 5 husband. She wanted to renew her life, change her life system. Therefore, she accepted the words of Jesus and she said to the world, to the people of Samaritan, there is a man, a prophet, more than a prophet, a Jesus. She was able to communicate the gospel to the people through this incident. But here in Nicodemus' story, he was not willing to give the place to God. He was searching for a simple wisdom. Spirituality makes you sometimes different. It became an adventurous experience for the people, those who accept it. Gandhiji, with his spirituality, that leads him to go through many experiences. We are nobody to judge his positions or his destinations. But he traveled along with his religious visions. Jesus traveled with his visions, which was given by the God to fulfill the will of God. That was, he was boldly presenting the gospel to the people. Jesus took the same thing to this man. And he said it in another word, 16, says, for God so loved the world that he has only begotten Son, and whoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. He pointed out that the Son of God has the power of giving the everlasting life. But this poor Nicodemus, even though he had any objections about Jesus, but he failed to accept Jesus, failed to receive the teachings which Jesus has given to him. Our spiritual desire is sometimes like that. We fail to give attention to the Word of God. We are simply searching, simply seeking, simply knocking, without a question, without a desire, without a need. That won't work out in our spirituality. But in this case of Samaritan woman, she accepted this and she proclaimed the gospel of Jesus. The second king is talk about two prophets. It's talk about Elijah and Elisha. Elisha called Elijah to the ministry. He left everything for the sake of ministry. Now it's a time. It's a turn and it's a time for Elisha to go to heaven. The Word of God says in 2 Kings chapter 2 verses 1 onwards, and it came to pass when the Lord was about to take up Elijah into the heaven by a whirlwind, the Elijah went with Elisha from the Gilgal. So Elisha is a senior, Elijah is a junior. The Elijah as a junior prophet and Elisha as a senior prophet. The senior prophet said, stay here please, for the Lord has sent me to Bethel. You stay by here, Bethel. I may go to another place, Bethel. So you live here peacefully. And he said to him, as your soul lives, as the Lord lives, I will not leave you. So they went down to Bethel. Bethel is a place where God people meet together for fellowship. Bethel. A calm place, a place where God makes you to be more safe, more happy. But this Elisha said, you can stay here and continue your ministry. What Elijah said. What Elijah said? No, I want to come with you. As the Lord lives, as the soul lives, I will not leave you alone. Then he said that I will go to Jericho. You stay back in Bethel. Jericho is a place where a lot of strifes, confusions, problems. Jericho was a city, placed a lot of things. You may have a peaceful situation. You live with a spirituality here. I want more experience. I want to give for more adventurous experience. And Elijah said, no, sir. As the Lord lives, as the soul lives, I will not leave you. I want to come to you. That's a phase of spirituality. Spirituality is not staying with a peaceful situation alone. It will go various kinds of experience. And again he says that Elijah, stay here. For the Lord has sent me on to Jordan. So I want to go to Jordan. Jordan is a place where the full of problems are there. That's the meaning of that word. So flooding is there. Instability is there. So you stay back with your spirituality here. And Elisha said, what he said? No, as the Lord lives and your soul lives, I will not leave you here. So again it happened. It says after Jordan, Elisha said to Elisha, ask what the Lord I do for you before I am taking away from you. Elisha said, please let me double portion of your spirit upon me. Elisha said, as he knows that Elijah is going to heaven. Elijah is living. Elisha says, one thing and the only thing, please let me have a double portion of the spirit be upon you. Be upon me. I want a double portion of the spirit. He recognized the needs. We were talking about the Nicodemus while he was approaching Jesus without feeling any need. He just wanted to know, make sure that whether Jesus is the right person or not. But when Jesus pointed out a certain spiritual element, Jesus said, come with me to one more phase, to leave where you are right now and come to me to experience the spirituality with me. He felt it as a threat. He went away. But he talked to the woman who was in a well in Samaria. She was ready to respond to Jesus and come with Jesus with a new spiritual understanding. She was experiencing the new changes in her life. Here in Elijah and Elisha's case, Elisha wanted one thing. Even though spirituality comes through various kinds of situations and problems, he was looking and listening to Elisha and said, Elisha said, I want double portion of the spirit which you are holding on now. Because the time and age which you are going to face, you already faced, is nothing when I compare to the days of challenges which is awaiting for me. So I need to perform like you perform in your days. But I know that I need a double strength. Here we need, as in a spiritual life, we need to recognize whether your soul is thirsting, whether your soul is having any appetite, whether your soul is having any thirst. So if it is there, you need to go one more step. Am I happy with my present situations in and around me? Or I am just put me to behave that I am satisfied? Then your soul will not be strengthened. Your spirituality will not give you any reward. That will give you reward only when you go with the steps which God put you to step adopt in your life. So in these three cases, Nicodemus went back. He didn't felt anything extra in his life because he was unwillingly to accept the challenges and the call from the Lord. Second person, the Samaritan woman, was willing to accept the challenges. So she experienced extraordinary things happen in her life. She find the satisfaction of life with the words of Jesus Christ. Not only her life satisfaction alone, he led many of the Samaritans. Samaritans was a mixed community. They did not know how to worship God. They did not know the scriptures of the world. They did not know the power of the gospel. But through this woman, she brought them peace and happiness to these people. Here the case of Elisha and Elijah. And Elisha said to him, Elijah said to Elisha, ask what you are really looking for before I am taking into heaven. I know my destination was sure, I am going to heaven. A God's own prophet, Elijah say, I am sure where I am going. I am going to reach my spiritual destination. So now is the time for you to ask me. The Elisha, without any doubt, says, what I want, what I recognize my need is to get double portion of the Spirit from you. So here, my friends, our challenges are increasing day by day. Crisis. More crises are coming up day by day. But don't be upset. The ability within you is not sufficient for you. The influences in your circumstances is sometimes not helping you. But the hope in God makes you to be a better person in your situations. As Elisha recognized that need, Elijah did 40 miracles, powerful miracles during his ministry. That is recorded. The man who held double portion of the Spirit, he performed 28 miracles. Just double. This is word of God. This is the power of God is exhibited in the lives of Elisha. You are so powerful, able to control the kings and lead people to go through various kinds of experiences. So I praise God for people, those who are having such an understanding. My ability is nothing But only my availability is something which will bring the glory to God. Judas Iscariot knows God for 3.5 years. Peter knows God almost same period. But these two people have different approaches. Peter failed in many areas. He underwent the ups and downs of spiritual experience with Jesus. Even he rejected Jesus once upon a time. 3 times in the most crucial day and time of Jesus Christ, Peter rejected him. But Iscariot never rejected Jesus. Iscariot said, I know him. I will find out him for you. He got 32 silver coin for that. He knows, he never rejected. But the final outcome is what? After seeing that Jesus was under persecution, he was so upset. Then his conscience pricked him and put him in judgment. And he said that, I am worthy to accept the capital punishment. He himself hanged him. A self-judgment. He was failed to realize the need of himself. He was looking more priority to the money only. That's what, while in the most crucial moment, he failed to turn to Jesus and ask for forgiveness. Peter, he did one thing, he ashamed of telling about Jesus to people. He rejected three times, which Jesus also prophesied, forecast, foretold to Peter. Peter, you're going to reject me 3 times. When the rooster crow in the morning, before that you will reject me 3 times. The time Jesus mentioned, before the rooster crow, everything Jesus mentioned to Peter. Peter, are you able to face this challenge? You are going to reject me 3 times. Peter rejected the 3 times because of the fear. But finally he turned to God. Finally he confessed before Jesus. And he realized that he made a mistake. He confessed. Both the disciples of Jesus Christ, one selected his own way. He also was under judgment. He put himself into judgment, capital punishment, hanging him to death. But Peter, he confessed his sin before God and got a forgiveness from the Lord. And God appointed him in the, reinstated him in the same position. He became a big apostle. He became the leader of the movement. Which one we would like to follow? Is the life of Peter or the life of Iscariot Judah? So your spirituality should have a destination. Then it will give you immense joy and happiness in your life. Thank you so much for watching today's Heart and Soul programs. And I am sure that God is sufficient for all of us. But deal with our spirituality and help us to be a power-packed center. Our home should be a power-packed center. Our church should be a power-packed center. Our individual life should be a power-packed center. May the God bless you with all these things. Thank you so much for watching today's Heart and Soul program. May the God bless you. Thank you. So will the world.
Shantini.